Hey everyone, exciting news for GDevelop users. There's a new built-in Tilemap feature. Previously, we had to rely on external editors like LDTK or Tile to create maps. But now it can all be done directly within the engine. This is a huge win and will save a lot of time. Now, while this is a game changer, there are a few limitations you should know about. We'll cover everything you need to know about the new object, its limitations, and how to handle collision with it. Okay, so if you're on the latest version of GDevelop, you should have this new object, which is Tilemap. So if we select this object, now you need to specify an atlas image. This should be an image that contains all the tiles you want to place in your game. Okay, so for this, I'll be making use of the Kenny Racing Pack, and in here, let's take sprite sheet. And I'm going to select our sprite sheet styles, and here we go. Now you need to specify the size of a tile in your sprite sheet. So for this, it should be 128, and here we go. So you can see this white rectangle around each tile. There we go. Now if we apply this, I'll drag my tile map object into the scene. Select the object. In here, you can make use of this tile map painter to paint your tile. So I'm going to select our very first tile right here, and I can draw. There we go, let's select ground, and here we go. So there you go, that's how easy it is to make maps with the new Tilemap objects. Now how do we manipulate tiles? So if I want to change a tile right here with my event, so how do I do this? Now to do this, let's go into events, let's add a new event, and in here I'm going to add an action. Let's select our new Tilemap object, and here we have four actions, where we remove tile on the grid and at position. Now these two actions do the same thing, but they work differently. So go on the grid, you need to specify the X and Y position of the tile you want to remove on the grid. So let's go back into our event. Now here's how you can identify your tile. So if I go back and in here, so on the grid, this first tile is identified on the X as 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Now on the Y, this is still 0 and this is 1. So if I want to pick, let's say we want to pick this tile right here. So identify this, we need to count. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3. This is 0 and this is 1. So to pick this tile, we need to set X position to 3 and our Y position to 1. So let's go back into our events in our grid coordinates. Let's set the X to 3 and the Y to 1. So if I preview this, as you can see, it removes that tile right there. Now how about removing a tile at the position? Let's close our preview. I'm going to add a new event. Let's disable this. Let's add an action, tilemap. And when it comes to at the position, this works for you specifying the X and Y position of the tile in our scene. So let's go back into our scene. And in here, let's say we want to remove this tile right here. So we have our tile. This is currently on the X position, it's 0. And on the Y position, we have it 512. Here we go. So if I want to remove this tile right here, what I can do is in our events, for the X, I can set this to 0, and for the Y, I can set this to 5112. So if I preview this, as you can see, it removes that tile right there. Now this is also going to work as long as you are within the bounds of that tile. Currently, we have the width of our tile to 128. So if I set the X to, let's say, 127, let's preview this. As you can see, it still removes the very first tile, but if I set this to, let's close our preview, let's set this to 128, and it's going to remove the second tile. So how do you change a tile? So to do this, let's close our preview, and in here, let's go back into our game scene, let's select our tile object. Now if I come into my shape painter and I hover over a tile, you can see we have this number right here, this is 1. Let's scroll the way to the bottom, we have this as 289, there we go. Now this number is called the ID and it's important for changing the tile. So to do this, so let's change our very first tile right here to this tile with the ID 289. So let's go into our events. I'm going to disable this. Let's add a new event. Let's add an action, tile map. Just like we have for our remove tile on the grid and at position, it works the same way. For this, I'll make use of the on the grid and we're changing this to 289, just like I explained earlier. The tile we want to change is at 0 on the X and 0 on the Y. So okay, and preview this. So there you go, as you can see our tile changed right there. You can also do the same, let's close this. Let's say we want to change this tile right here. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And let's set the grid X to 4. Okay, let's preview this. And here we go. And also let's add some tiles up here. Let's close this new scene. Let's go into our tile. Let's pick this tile right here. Let's place this here, here, here. Now, if I preview this, it's no longer going to change this style anymore. Let's preview this, and here we go. And the reason why is this style is no longer at the grid coordinates 4 and 0, rather it's at 0, 1, 2, 3. It's at 4 and 3. So if you want to change the style, go back in our events. Let's set this to 4 and on the right, 3. Okay, so if we preview this, and here we go. So how do you handle collisions? Okay, so here I have a sprite object, which I've given the platformer object behavior to. So if I apply this and preview, it falls right through. Now I want this object to collide with our tilemap. To do this, let's close our preview. Let's go into our tilemap object. And in here, you need to select the tiles you want to serve as the floor. So if I want this, let's go with this and this. Now the red rectangle around the tile shows that the hitbox has been activated. If I click on it again, deactivated, click on it, activated. Now also, let's go into our behaviors. Let's add a behavior. Let's select our platform behavior and apply this. Now if I preview this, as you can see, our player object now collides with our tilemap object. So I can move on it. I can jump on it. I can also collide with it. Now in the properties of the tilemap object, you can also go ahead and erase tiles by clicking on this right here, erase. You can flip tiles, let's select the tile. You can flip horizontally and you can flip vertically. So if I select horizontal flip, so let's select this, and as you can see, it's flipped horizontally. Let's uncheck that, let's select vertical flip, and you can see it's flipped vertically. So there you go, that's all you need to know about the new tilemap object. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. I'll see you guys in my next tutorial.